गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
PPT is visible, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, students, in last class I was discussing about the selectors, simple selector, class selector, ID selector, and some of the examples also we have seen. And these are all the found properties which we are using in the program to give a style to the web page. And we have also seen the different styles of giving types of different types of styles which we apply for the web page, that is inline style sheet. Inline style sheet, document style sheet, and the external style sheet we have seen. And we have also seen the layering. Layering is nothing but the positioning of a object or the positioning of a content in the web page. That is, first we have seen the height and width. When I was explaining the image tag, I gave the height and width value. Why we give height and width value? To modify or to resize the image. Generally, what happens if you don't give the size of a image, then what is the exact size of an image that it will display? If the image is very big, I don't want to display that image so big. So what I can do is I can change the width and height value, and also the top value, left value, and top value also we have seen how to change. In last class I explained the example of z index value and how this z index works we have seen, and the one example I was about to explain this position, or a position that is relative and absolute. So before I move on to this relative and absolute, so I want to ask few questions, students. I'll select randomly, and I ask the questions. Banu Prakash, can you hear me, Banu Prakash?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I what is the font size, not which font size is bigger, H6 or H3? Which font size is bigger, H6 or H3?
H6, ma'am.
H6 font size is bigger.
Yes, ma'am.
How? How? Because it is H6 and it is H3. Am I right?
No, ma'am, not like that.
Then. You're from BCA background. Have you studied this web in your graduation?
Yes, ma'am, I studied.
Okay.
Ma'am, can I say?
No, wait, wait, wait. I'll ask one by one. I'll come to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Bhanuprakash. Yes, Dakshani, you can tell.
Ma'am, H3 is bigger font, ma'am, because one is bigger. When we go 1, 2, 3, 6 is the smallest one, ma'am, smallest font.
Yes, correct. See, students, so many times I repeated, I told that gradually the font size is decreasing in the heading. H1 it has a bigger font size. H2 is compared to H1, it is smaller. H3 still more smaller. So gradually the font size is decreasing. See, students, why I'm asking question is I want to know whether you are understanding or not, whether you are following or not. Please, if you have any doubt, you don't think that it is a silly doubt or small doubt. Because if it is an online class, then you would have come to my cabin. If you have any doubt, also you would have come to me. The physical conversation is different than the online conversation. Please don't hesitate to ask any doubts. So whatever the doubts you have, you can ask. If anything, if I am not able to explain, then I'll check once. I'll go back and I'll see if anything. If I am not able to explain, then I'll search it and I'll try to find the solution or answer. Then I'll come back to you. But please, whatever the doubts you have, you please ask. From the beginning, I'm repeating this at H1. And we have seen so many examples also. Bhanuprakash, you are not seeing the examples. You are not seeing the programs. Yesterday's class, how much I highlighted.
I have seen it.
Then why you have that confusion? See, students, whatever the doubt you have, you please ask. Diksha? Diksha, can you hear me, Diksha? Are you there? Harshit, Harshit,
Ma'am.
in the web page, when you give any content, it may be image or it may be any table or any text. Generally, it will be left align or right align. By default, which alignment it will take?
Ma'am.
You did not understand my question.
Yeah, ma'am.
When you display any content, it may be image or any some message, some information. So how it will display, whether it will be left justified or right justified, the default alignment.
Left, ma'am.
Yes, Harshit.
Left, ma'am.
Left. Can you change the alignment of a table? Of a table, I'm asking. Can you change the alignment of a table?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you there?
Yes, ma'am, we can change it, ma'am.
Okay. But I'm asking, next question is for Huma. ma. Are you there, Huma? Huma, when I call for the attendance, that time you will respond.
Hello,
Many
ma'am.
times I then respond, no? Can you change the position of a table? Can you change the alignment of a table?
Yes, ma'am.
How? How? Please respond. If you don't know, you can you tell me directly you don't know. If you know, you tell me the answer.
Yeah, ma'am, I was confused with that, ma'am.
Confused for what?
I'm under the alignment and
do you know is there any table tag in the HTML?
Yeah, ma'am. Table tag like we use.
Wait. What's the syntax? What are the tags we use in table tag?
TD, TH.
What is TD? What is
For
TD?
rows, ma'am.
For rows, we use TD. What is TH?
Ma'am, table header.
Okay.
Table header and table caption.
Table caption. How you give table caption?
Ma'am, I have that confusion about this, ma'am.
You tell me what you are from BCA background. You studied this programming in your graduation.
Yes, ma'am. I studied, ma'am.
Okay. What confusion you have in table tag? Tell me.
Ma'am, that in alignment only, ma'am.
About alignment, you have confusion. When I explained, you did not listen, did not understand.
No, ma'am. Today I have some network issue. I can't hear properly.
No, I'm not asking about today. I'm asking about the previous classes.
Yeah, ma'am. I'm listening all the classes.
What is TR?
Table row, ma'am.
Table row. Okay. Panindra?
Yes, ma'am.
What tag we use for to display like this?
Subscript, ma'am.
Subscript. Correct. Sushma? Sushma? Sushma. Sushma is not there.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am.
Where were you, Sushma? 3-4 times I called you. What is the syntax to display this? This? What is the syntax to display this? I mean, what is the tag? What is the tag to display this? Yes, Sushma, can you hear me? Yes, students, please respond quickly.
Hello, ma'am.
Ah, yes. Yes, Sushma. You understand the question? Yeah, you are audible.
Ma'am, subscript.
Subscript. To display this, we use subscript.
No, ma'am.
Yes? Wait. Spurti?
Yes, ma'am.
Spurti, which tag we use to display this? The circled one, circled X. See, students, again I'm repeating, if you are not understanding, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. See, simple questions I'm asking: header, heading tag, subscript, superscript, value, just table alignment, how we align the table. I have explained the examples also. And how many, tell me honestly, how many of you opened the programs which I uploaded in GCR? At least open the program. Yes, how many of you opened? I can come to know who are listening and who are opening the program and executing. My girls have become very busy during these online classes. Please, students, execute the programs which I shared in the Google Classroom. If we are getting, and in the lab also, I told you, if you have any errors, you please share your screen and we can see what type of error, what is the problem you are facing. Okay. Yes, students, this is the first assignment question. So today I'll upload these questions in the GCR. I'll create assignment for this first assignment, and the deadline for this assignment is 6th June. On or before 6th June. By 4:30. Should submit the assignment. The questions are not so tough. All the questions are simple only. If you are not getting any answer for these questions, and I have given very less questions. Only 6 questions I gave for first assignment.
Ma'am, 6th June or 10th June, ma'am? You have mentioned the date below as 10 there.
10th June.
Yes, 10th June. 10th June. 10th June is a deadline for the submission of the assignment. Today is first. So 10 days I have given for 6 questions. I don't want any late submission, students.
Ma'am, you have to write in a piece of paper or?
No, better. No, if you have books, you can write. I know now lockdown shops are not open. If you have a book, you can write in the book, because when you come to college, then you have to submit those assignments. So if you are not getting books, you can write in sheets. Whichever is comfortable for you students. I am not telling you have to use books only or sheets only. Whichever is comfortable. But when you come back to college, you have to submit that. The hard copy you have to submit.
Okay.
So by 10th,
we can write it in A4 paper sheet.
Yeah, you can write. By 10th June, you have to submit the PDF, the soft copy. You have to submit to the GCR. So when you come for the offline class, that time you have to submit the hardware. Yeah, it may be a notebook or a A4 sheets. So these six questions. So see, 10th June is a deadline to submit the assignment. 10th June by 4:30. Navya?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you display the can we display the font in italic in the web page? Manoj?
Yes,
Manoj,
ma'am.
D? What is the tag?
I, ma'am, small I, italic tag.
Okay. Yes, okay. Manoj, are you there, Manoj?
Yes, ma'am.
What is inline style sheet? What is inline style sheet? Quickly. Raman, what is inline style sheet?
I don't know.
Why? You did not understand the second lab program? See, students, I cannot ask each and every student that whether you understood header tag or whether you understood inline tag or external style sheet or document style sheet. If you have doubt, then you should ask me. If you are not understanding, you should tell me that you have not understood. The students, the second program I'm explaining once again. Why? Because here we are using different style sheet and headings also. So many have doubt in headings and style sheet or style sheet. I doubt whether you people understood ordered list, unordered list, table tag, mark tag, chart tag. Yes. Understood.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let me explain this once again. These students generally in XHTML, we have the tags, header tags. So H1 to H6, tags we have. The size and the color of those tags are predefined. If you want to change, you can change. It is not that if it is predefined, you cannot change. You can change the size of H1 tag and H2 tag, H3 tag, but the predefined heading tag, size of H1 tag and compared to H1 tag, H2 tag, H3 tag, the sizes are gradually decreasing. The sizes are gradually decreasing. Here, I think you can see this style tag. See, in HTML, or when you create a web page, as I told, when you create a web page, there are different pages are involved. So designing a different page, it will take so much of time. So to overcome the drawback of that, we have a CSS or cascading style sheet. In cascading style sheet, there are three types or there are three levels. That is document level, inline style sheet, and external style sheet. The document level style sheet is nothing but this, the style tag. And in the selector also, we have seen that this H1 tag, this is a simple selector. The simple selector will be applied to whole body of the program. Correct, no, students? In last class, we have seen that it will be applied to whole body of the program. And this is a inline style sheet. In a single line, we are applying the style. The single line we are applying the style, and this is a external style sheet. This is a external style sheet. This external style sheet is, that is 5.css. In 5.css file, whatever the font color, or if you are giving the style to the table or ordered list or unordered list, so whatever the style you are giving, that style will be defined in that 5.css file. When you call that 5.css file in the program, then that those properties will be applied in this to this HTML program. To this HTML program. See here, this is a document level style sheet. This here, I have defined the style for H1 tag, H6 tag, and unordered list. H1 tag, H2 tag, and unordered list. H6 tag. The font color is, both the font color is green. And for the list also, I have changed the color. Generally, students, if you are not mentioning the color, then the text color will be black color. If you want to change, you can change the text color. You can change red, green, maroon, so many different colors you have. You can change the colors. Here, you can see here. I have used unordered list. Under unordered list, C program and Java I have given. This execution also I have shown. This is H6 tag, and this is what tag it is. Sorry, this is not. This is H1 tag. H1 tag. It is displaying in green color. And down you can see here H6 tag. Or I'll do one thing, students.
Ma'am, H2 tag is closed twice, ma'am.
Yes. Student, this is a simple for header tags. See how the font size is gradually decreasing. How the font size is gradually decreasing. Now, what I told is you can also change the font size. You can also change the font size. How? Style tag. See students, the font size of a H6 is lesser compared to the other heading tags. So what I am doing, I am giving the style tag, H6 tag. Font size in. So this is a simple selector, no need to call in the body of the program. Yes, correct? No,
yeah, tag matte ma'am, style tag was like
padilala. Yes, students, it will not show the error. Style tag. See, this size is changed now. Previous, in the previous output, it was not displaying clearly. So it means not clearly means the font size was small. I'm making it to 26. Yes, the size is changing. Yes, students, you please practice the programs which I have given in the GCR. Okay. In last class, I was, and whatever the doubt you have, you please ask students. You ask questions if you have any doubts. Yes, students, in last class, I was discussing about this z-index value. So z-index is used to change the position of a object or position of a content. See here, the z-index value -1 I gave. So if you give the z-index value -1, then you see how it will, what will be the output. Z index -1. See here, students, in this program, I'm using z index value and the position value. Z index value and the position value. And you see here, coming to the body of the program, in the body of the program, what I have given first the heading tag, that is H1, the Z index property, and the statement that is good morning, and the image tag. Then the image tag. And here I have defined the style for the image tag. What style I have defined? I am specifying the position of the image and Z index value of the image. Yes, I am giving style only for this image tag. Only for the image tag, and then I am displaying a statement. I am displaying this statement. I'll remove the students. I'll remove that style. I'm removing the style. I have removed the style and I am displaying the, I have displayed the image. So according to the body of the program, it will display. Correct? H1 tag, good morning message, image tag, and the paragraph. Correct? No? Now, I include the style. Now I'm including the style. So here, what happens when you give the Z index value minus one, the content will be the image will be placed behind the heading, behind the, so the position it is taking from the beginning. Here you can see, here now you can see, every time you need to save, students, if you don't save then it will not show in the output. So what is happening, it is displaying the image as a background, and the H1 tag, good morning, and the paragraph tag. Now what I do, I will change the position of the image. Relative. So there are two types to position the image, absolute and relative. When I change it to relative, how it is, it will affect in the output, we will see, students. See. So where exactly the image is put in the body tag, from there, there it is displaying. When I give the position value relative, when I give the position value relative, it is displaying where exactly I have placed my image. See, first is the heading tag, next is a good morning message, and next I have the image tag. Next I have the image tag. So where exactly I have given the image tag, that it is displaying when I put the position value relative. So one more example I'll show. See here, students, see here I have taken the due tag, first due tag, second due tag, and the third due tag. As I told, this due tag, it creates a container. So in that container, you can add whatever the data you want to display, or it is like a box. So to that box, you can give a different colors. To that box, you can give a different colors. I mean, a different color. Colors means the background color, and the index value you can change, and left position, left side value, top side value, and the width value also you can change. So here, this is the first due tag. So means this is the first box. The background color of this box is red, and the width is 300 pixel, height is 100 pixel, and the position is relative. Position is relative. And top is 10 pixel, left is 80 pixel. And the set index value is 2. And one more div tag, second div tag I have, that is background color is yellow. Background color is yellow. Width is same 300 pixel, height is 100 pixel, same as the first div tag. And the position is absolute. Position is absolute. And top and left value is changed. Z index value is 1. And I have, this is a third div tag. The background color is green. The background color is green. The width value is 300 pixel, height is 100 pixel, position is relative, top and height value. So now I will run this program. Relative means where exactly I have declared these values. So there, from there it will display. Yes, students, I'll open the code also. So this is the first div tag. The background is red. See, the size of all the boxes are same because the height and width value is same everywhere. The height and width value is same. The position is relative. Top is 10 pixel and left is 80 pixel. See here, you can see the left is 80 pixel. Coming to the second box, second div tag, the size is same, width and height value. The position is relative. Top is 60 pixel and left is 35. See students, here the left is 35, but for the red box, top is 10. So that's why the space here is less and the left pixel value is 80. Yes, you are getting how the boxes are placed?
Yes, ma'am.
Now,
yes, ma'am.
I will change this left for first box. I will change the value, left value 80 to 180. 80 to 180, I will change. See. So it has moved 180 pixel left. Yes, like this, you can change the position of a image. And now what I do, the position is relative. I will change the position value to absolute, students. So I'm changing it to absolute. So you observe how it will change in the reflect in the program. So where that Where is that image? Where is that image? Anybody? Where that image went? Now again it is displaying. Can you tell me the answer for this in the next class, students? When I change the relative value to absolute, that image, that box was not displaying. Why? Can you tell me the answer in the next class? Respond, no? At least you say no, ma'am. You will not tell or... Students, I'll stop here. The students, from next class, I am starting the JavaScript, introduction of to JavaScript. Answer of attendance, students. 1.
Yes, ma'am.
2.
Yes, ma'am.
3.
Yes, ma'am.
4.
Yes, ma'am.
6.
Yes, ma'am.
7.
Yes, ma'am.
8.
Yes, ma'am.
9.
Present, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
10. 11.
Yes, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am. He's put in chat box.
Okay. 13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Yes, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am. She has put in chat box.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20. 20. Last class also absent. 20. 21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Yes, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26.
Present, ma'am.
27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Yes.
31.
Yes, ma'am.
Mohit is absent, no? Mohit is there?
Ma'am, Harshit is also there.
No, ma'am. He has some network issues.
Mohit is there, ma'am.
Ma'am, Harshit is present, ma'am.
Okay. 20 is present. Then he did not respond. Okay. Thirty? 31?
Present, ma'am. 30.
Okay, okay. 32.
Present, ma'am.
33. 34.
Present, ma'am. 34.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, okay. 36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Yes, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Yes, ma'am.
41. Sai Kumar. Absent, huh? 42.
Present, ma'am.
43.
Present, ma'am.
44.
Present, ma'am.
45.
Present, ma'am. Mic issue.
Okay. 46. 47.
Present, ma'am.
48.
Present, ma'am. Mic issue, ma'am.
Okay. 49.
Present, ma'am.
50.
Present, ma'am.
51.
Present, ma'am.
52.
Present, ma'am.
53.
Present, ma'am.
55.
54. Present, ma'am.
Okay, okay. 56.
Present, ma'am.
57.
Present, ma'am.
58.
Present, ma'am.
59.
Present, ma'am.